Incredible. After hearing Debbie Duncan sing, starts with a quotation from Vincent van Gogh, "The way to know life is to love many things."
Hi.
This would be good enough. After hearing Debbie Duncan sing, "The way to know life is to love many things," Vincent van Gogh. The way to know life is to love many things. One way life can be known is to love many things. Loving many things can bring knowledge to life itself. The way to know life is to love many things. Live, love, know life.
Lilac's gone?
Okay. In late July, the lilacs have lost their pinks and whites, but the bushes remain green, and what is that fragrance wafting in? Something tells me it's not just memory. The Wait for John. Urban lake to our right, asphalt path. Bikers and walkers going past, we talk of our children, glands, lesions, injections, healthcare gone amok. I have known your wise eyes for 17 years, but sometimes nothing is enough, and this is all a joke in a sense, but more serious also than cancer itself. The heart is a muscle, but metaphorically it is not even inside us, scattered all over the world. We go out to it always in our desire and compassion, and it breaks every day if we care enough. The pleasure in doing harm is boundless. The pleasure of caring takes work and focus. This world is too much sometimes. You talk of a book that says the so-called bipolar make the best leaders at times of crisis because they are realistic, creative, empathetic, and resilient. Abraham Lincoln is exemplary. Maybe normality is craziness, a way of lying and assuming into being a world that doesn't exist. Harm can only result. Traffic on road ringing late overcomes the singing birds. A slow runner waddles by, wishing to lose weight. Good luck to him. And I complain about the heat in my apartment. You talk of humidity, an oldest child going to college in a month. Old age doesn't sneak up. It suddenly appears and constricts our heart, muscle, and metaphor. This day isn't this day. It is our wishes and projections, our whole last week heaped, and what we hoped heaped onto that. This day sits well outside our concerns, some sort of moving in the air, some sort of lapping at the edge of the lake. We will die not knowing where we lived, having cared too much. Poets should not be in gyms because we should be scrawny and sensitive and smoking cigarettes. Because we should look like we could blow away in a slight breeze. Because we are uptight and have a high metabolism anyway. Because we are so smart we see through all the jock bullshit. Because we consider line breaks more important than breaking personal bests. Because we are too sensitive for the dank odor there. Because our vocabulary intimidates our gym mates and we don't know how those gorillas will take it out on us. Because we take no pleasure in slamming barbells to the floor after a set and saying, "Ah!" Because all poets are alike and none of us like gyms. Because gym people appreciate neither irony nor onomatopoeia. Because gym people grin big and smug even when insecure in a manner determined to put us in our place. Because, after Descartes, we value the bodiless mind over the soma. Because exercise hurts our delicate bodies. Because, except for Charles Olson, male poets should not be big. And female poets, if they are big, can be so only naturally or through imbibing. Because we prefer talking to doing. Because poets prefer pretty versifying to bristling brawn. Evolution is right because no engineer in her right mind would design the human body with its most delicate and important organ at the end of an isthmus called the neck. No engineer in her right mind would not protect that organ with something like the ribs. After all, didn't the Greeks believe the heart was the brain in part due to its protection? No engineer in her right mind would create something as flimsy as the knee, shoulders so easily dislocatable, or bones susceptible to such easy cracking. Ever hear of graphite? The elements gone chance, glorious beings bumping and fumbling our way toward whatever happens next. And the engineers didn't create laughter. Your eyes, so open, so vulnerable, twinkle at my goofiness. And this all matters so little and so much. What I learned in the past year, age 46 and 47. You are never too old to learn. You can trust nobody. You need to trust some simply to survive. There is no bottom line. You can never know anyone. You can never know yourself. Those you know best can always surprise you, for good and ill. There is no bottom line. When the bottom falls out, you only go down as far as the next floor. That floor, too, can fall out. There is no such thing as earth. Freedom often appears when you have very little left to lose. You always have more to lose. Even after death, you can lose dignity, depending on what they do to your corpse. I am a hippie at heart. Give me value over money any day. I will wave my freak flag high. Destruction can be the most loving and creative act. You might as well respect yourself. If you don't, nobody will. People are capable of anything, from sublime charity to sublime cruelty. Anyone is capable of anything, given certain circumstances. Don't think you know yourself. We construct ideas of how we are that have a tenuous hold on facts and context. We are stupider than we think. We think we behave according to our beliefs. We are smarter than we allow ourselves to think. The person you lie to the most is yourself. The next moment is a gift and a curse. You can depend on nobody. Sometimes you can depend on yourself. Everybody needs someone else, even a hermit. If you want something done, then you need to get busy. Desperation, properly focused, can be a great motivator. You may always be surprised by finding what is your calling. Whining, when done with nuance and theatrical flair, can manipulate people. Subtle flamboyance and histrionics are often, sadly, convincing. The only reward for doing good is knowing you did it. There is no substitute for the word love. Those who say writers shouldn't use it are wrong. Sometimes your head has no top. A kind smile can mean everything for a while. Every kind smile ends. There are people who would rather you not exist. You can take nothing for granted. We can't live without assumptions. I wish someone could see me as I see myself. I can't see myself. I is an evolution. You need to stop thinking the horizon can be reached. You are where you are, where you are. Given the right effort and perceptive angle, anything can be beautiful. But crazy people are sometimes simply crazy, sometimes not. Trust your instincts, not your desires. Nothing is exactly effortless. When an old friend is on the other line, you can finally relax. The human capacity for forming groups from which to hate can never be underestimated. People are stupid. People are too smart for their own good. Kindness pops up in the strangest places. There is no such thing as goodbye.